Hello, this is Dr. Patrick Hanley at Hanley Innovations. Today I'd like to show how to analyze an L-shape hydrofoil. And I'm using the 3D foil vortex lattice software. And I start with the program start with a square wing, which is default. So what I'm going to do is to change the square wing so that it gives us the dimensions of our hydrofoil. So we start with a span, and the span is going to be 0.66 meters for the hydrofoil. The left chord is 0.18, and the right chord is also 0.18. Next, I change the X resolution of the analysis in such a way to get more accuracy for a cambered wing. So it's going to be 18. And the Y resolution remain at 16. The next thing, I change the position, put it right back at the origin. And then the left airfoil, I want to select a hydrofoil airfoil. So I click the select button, and I'm going to choose a hydrofoil from the UIUC database, and I'm going to choose the Epler 817 airfoil. I click that, and then click OK. And then for the right airfoil shape, I select also the Epler and click OK. And then I click OK to get out of the airfoil editor, the surface editor. And then I want to see what it looks like in three dimensions. Here we are now looking at the surface of the hydrofoil. That is the mean cambered surface, but I want to look at the outer surface. To do that, I again select and edit the surface shape, go to the options, and I click the show outer surface and shade outer surface option. And going back to the three-dimensional view, we see we now have a 3D rendering of the hydrofoil. Another thing I would like to do is to click the group button, select my surface number one in the group, and then I want to lock it to prevent it from accidentally moving as I'm working with this hydrofoil shape. Now that we have the horizontal section of the hydrofoil, we want to now work on the vertical section of the L shape. So we double click, and we can set this will bring up surface number two, which is going to be the vertical section. And we can set the options to show the outer surface again, shade the surface. And then we want to make a span of 0.99 meters, and of course the left chord and the right chord will be the same as before, 0.18 for the left and right chord respectively. And the X resolution I want to keep at 16, and because it's the span resolution, I'm going to keep it the same for all of the airfoil shapes. And then for the vertical section, I'm going to again use the Epler airfoil. So click select, it's already there, so click OK. And for the right airfoil shape, select and click OK. Now this is the very important part for making the vertical section. We have to change the dihedral angle to 90. And then this is also important, the left face angle, I wanted to make it 90, and the right face angle 90. This means that the faces would be in the same direction as the foil. So this is what it looks like. We see this is the horizontal section, and here we have the vertical section, and we have the faces pointing in 90 degrees on the dihedral. So what we have to do now is to join them together, and I can just move it over and we can see we can join them together. But that's not really good practice, because we can see that we have some sort of discontinuity between the horizontal and the vertical section. What I would like to do is to introduce a third surface that will be a transitional surface between the two sections. So we are going to look at a transitional surface. So I'm going to do a side view and move this a little bit away to give some room to work with. Go back to the top view. And I'm going to double click. Let me bring it in a bit. Double click a bit to introduce the transitional surface. And for this case, I'm going to make the span 0.025 meters, because it's a very short surface, and make the left chord 0.18 as before, the left and the right chords 0.18, and the X resolution, the airfoil resolution, I'm going to keep at 16. And because the span is so short, I'm going to decrease the Y resolution. You don't really have to, but if it's very short, you can really make it small, maybe like 4, and it would go analyze a little bit faster. And then I'm going to go to the visualization options again, show the outer surface, and shade the surface. So this is what we have now. We see we have all the three sections. We have the horizontal section, the vertical section, and the transitional section. There's one more thing we have to do on the transitional section, and that is I'm going to set it at a dihedral angle. So this is the third edit, and here we have the transitional surface. I'm going to set it at a 45 degree dihedral, almost the average between the horizontal and the vertical surface. However, on the left face, that is the face facing the vertical surface, I'm going to make that angle of that surface 90 degrees, and that's going to match the vertical section. Actually, that's the right face. The left face is, I should make 0 degrees because it's facing the horizontal section. And then the right face, I'll make 90 degrees, as I said before, to match the horizontal section. So when we look at it, we see something that looks like this. And what I need to do is actually to bring them closer in this screen, so we'll be able to work with them a little better. So we can bring them closer, and then I can show you a little better picture in this screen. And the next step is to join them together. And I'm going to use the Easy Snap button. So click Easy Snap, click Surface 3, and click Surface 1, and then that will be snapped. Surface 3 will automatically snap to Surface 1, then click the Easy Snap again, click Surface 2, and click Surface 3, and now we see them all snap together. So now that I have the sections of the hydrofoil together, the L-Hydrofoil together, what I like to do is to group them and click the group button, and then group them and then lock them so that they will not move out of place as we do the analysis. So to do the analysis, I would like to click the flow button, and I'll like to use an angle of attack of 4 degrees and a speed of 8 meters per second. Usually the fluid type is air if we are doing airplanes, but seeing that we're doing a hydrofoil, click fluid type water, fluid type other, and then we can use a different number of different water settings. We just click the first one, fresh water. Then we can just go to the report, click OK, go to the report menu and click forces, moments. And this will give you the forces and moments for these conditions acting on the hydrofoil. Here we see the lift force is 2000 newtons or 538 pounds. At these conditions, we'll have a drag force and we'll also have a side force. To get a more detailed reading or report, we go to the report menu and then we look at the report summary table. And this will give us a little bit more details of what we are looking at. We have the total lift, the total side force, etc., roll moments, yaw moments, things like that, and a power of 1.54 horsepower required to drive that hydrofoil. And we can also look at the reports again and look at the individual surface table, and this will give us the individual surface table will tell us what each of the surfaces are doing. We can get a report for the surface 1, 2, and 3. A few years ago, I looked at a similar hydrofoil situation, and basically, I used the same Epler airfoil, but I modified it, and I'll show you how to do that. We can look at surface 1, we edit it, and go to the left airfoil, select, and here I'm going to modify this airfoil. I'm going to change its thickness. Click the modify airfoil box, and I'm going to change its thickness to 12.6, and I'm going to change its camber to 1.7. Click OK, and here we now have a modified airfoil. Camber 12.6, 1.7, and we can do that for the left airfoil as well. The right airfoil as well. So we modified that airfoil. Then we go to surface 2, and we can do the same thing. Modify, and for the left airfoil we select to modify, and then finally for the airfoil 3. We do edit and we select this one, and for the right airfoil we select to modify it, and here we have a completely we can see our joint is very smooth, all the airfoils are the same, and basically we now look at the reports and we can see the force moments. With a new camber setting, the force is 1,856 newtons or 417 pounds. And we can make some other modifications and do some other settings, such as changing the fluid type so that it will match the report that I did a couple years ago. But essentially, this is how you will use the 3D foil software to analyze an L-shaped hydrofoil. This is Dr. Patrick Hanley at Hanley Innovations. More information can be found at www.hanleyinnovations.com. Thanks for listening.